what is it, like 2018 or something? Hi, I am burnt out on frickin' YouTube. I feel like everyone was talking about burnout in like 2018. Is this a thing, or am I just like not remembering? Yeah, this is basically just a ramble. I feel like I just need to get it like off of my chest. I think, like, so we all know, I assume that anyone watching this is probably like dedicated to watching these kind of things. But anyways, I did 100 videos back to back with Ursula, and that just fried my frickin' brain. And ever since, I've just kind of been really out of it. I've been able to put up like vlogs and stuff, but as for like writing out an advice video or anything, oh my god, my brain is just like, I can't handle it. Like, I sit down and I go to write, and nothing is coming, guys. But yeah, I think the thing is, like, I'm not super burnt out on making comics or anything. I know Ursula's a bit tired because she has a lot on her plate, but I've been having like lots of fun, like working on my novels, getting Honey Walls out, getting other things done, working on new projects. I'd really like to kind of just sit down and do some OC story time type videos, but I don't know. I think part of it is like I'm getting in my own way about it, where I'm just like, oh my god, no one cares about this. My channel is dead. I'm dead. I'm garbage, and I'm like hiding away from YouTube. None of this is true, and I shouldn't be on my own case about that kind of stuff, but this is where my brain's at, and I figured I might as well just, like, get it out there into the world that I'm just kind of, I just feel a little down about the whole YouTube thing right now. I want to do it more. I want to have fun, and I need to focus on, like, what I have fun doing, because I do have fun talking about like how to make comics, and I do have a lot of fun when people are really excited about like advice I give. I feel like I've just given so much at this point that I don't know. I feel like my advice is useless in a little at this point. Like, I've said so much that I couldn't possibly say more. I want to do like those like fairy tale things, but I don't know. It's just too much work. That's also part of it. It's just, I feel very flooded with like outside work aside from YouTube. And I feel like an obligation to do YouTube, which is heckin' so much trouble. I'm not super stressed about the COPPA thing. I don't know. I think everyone's talking about that, but I don't know. I think it's just because I don't even do super tons of monies on here, so I guess that's my dealio on that whole shebang. Yeah, I just want to make comics. I want to make stories, and I want to tell you guys about my stories, and I want to do other things, but I don't want to completely change the focus of the channel and disappoint everybody. But it's also like a pain in my little tushy. I don't want to have forgotten to do videos so much that only like the Patreon vlogs are going up, and you're like, oh, is this a vlog channel now? Because it's not. I like to throw up the vlogs on here, because like the idea of making a new channel stresses me the heck out, though I probably should move all the vlog stuff to another channel. Like, I was a whole other like harebrained scheme I was having was creating like a separate vlog channel and trying to do weekly vlogs over there, because like I've been having a lot of fun doing vlog stuff, and it kind of gets me out of the house doing things, because I'm like, oh no, I don't have anything cool to put in my vlog, I better do something exciting. But maybe that would just like stress me out entirely, I don't know. Exciting things being like taking my dogs to buy them Christmas presents, like that kind of stuff. Like, I don't have to go to the rodeo every week. Another thing is my dogs right now have been stressing me out. Not because they're bad, just because the one got sick, and then she got the other one sick, and then they got sick again. So like they had like a stomach flu that they passed around to each other, which was great, and it cost us money. We're not bad for money. We're just like, it was just a double whammy because they were so sick, they were up all night. Like, we had to take them on little bathroom trips throughout the night, like 7 times a night, because their little stomach bug. And so we really had to get medication to like help them out with that. So that was a whole thing. And now they all have kennel cough, because one of my little puppy, she was really scared of dogs. So we signed her up for daycare so she could get to meet dogs and you know, build some dog confidence. And she built up so much dog confidence, and I'm really proud of her. She's no longer afraid of Pomeranians. She's a freaking husky, like, dude. But anyway, she's no longer afraid of dogs, but she did, however, get kennel cough, and it was one of the strains that's kind of not protected against by vaccinations, because she had all her vaccinations. Anyways, she got that, and she gave it to everyone. So it's just been nonstop dogs oozing messes all over the floor, and I'm kind of going like a little bit insane, and the idea of sitting down and making a YouTube video is driving me crazy. And on top of that, then I'm doing NaNoWriMo, and last year I gave up on NaNoWriMo because I don't know, I just got really depressed, and someone in the comment section said I was just sad. It was depression. It lasted the whole stint of NaNoWriMo, which means it was depression, because depression is, you know, a feeling of depression for more than 3 weeks. So, heckin' suck it, comment person trying to dictate how I feel. But anyways, I got a depression then, and I didn't finish. And the year before, I didn't finish because that was when me and Ursula's first cat, she got a blood clot. Because then we'd gone to the overnighter write-in. So we'd stayed up all night, and we went to Tim Hortons. And we got home, and we went to sleep, and when I got up for a shower, there was, like, screaming downstairs. I thought it was, like, kids outside, but no, it was my cat, and she had a blood clot, and we took her to the emergency room, and she had to be put down. She was, like, 4 years old at the time, and, you know, like, I wasn't able to finish after that, kind of, obviously, and I guess this is, like, the third year now, and like I really am working really hard to kind of get back on the NaNoWriMo novel writing horse, and it's kind of, I wouldn't say it's a lot of pressure, like there is pressure to do it. I'm not gonna hate myself if I don't do it, but I really want to get back on doing a streak of doing this and really just enjoying writing again and kind of starting some new things. And you know, now that Honeywalls is over, which was such a big part of like my writing life for such a long time, that now I need to, like, I really want to finish. And I think I've just been putting most of my focus on like staying ahead of the curve, and hopefully I get my 50,000 words and I put out my new novel eventually, because I'm working on like another novel. I have so many freaking novels, guys, but I'm working on completing like the fifth draft of another novel after that, which is the Books of Avo, and I really want to do like the OC kind of videos about that, and character designs with Ursula. I think that'd be really cool. And I'm also really, really stressed out because after the holidays, which I know is going to happen like really fast, like it feels agonizingly slow, but it's also really fast. But after that, I have my surgery, and I'm kind of upset about that because I don't get to go to any conventions this year, and it feels like I'm gonna fall behind on a lot of things, and I think that stresses me out a lot. I think it's just a lot of stress, and yeah, I want to do YouTube. I feel like I need to get this like off my little chesty chest, because for real, like I felt like the past few like live streams, like I haven't even been super focused while doing them. And, like, I just want to do better, you know? I don't know why I'm having such a sappy day, okay? Like, sorry. Like, I'm really doing fine, like, honestly. Like, look at Moonlight. Like, it got, like, almost $18,000. Oh my god, guys, this was so much. Like, that was really overwhelming, too. Like, honestly. I'm gonna work on printing that and shipping that, and that's gonna be a lot of my time, but I really like packing orders, even if it's like 400. I'm gonna die, but like I'll be happy while I do it, and I'm just really proud of how well that has gone. And I hope moving forward we can do more stuff. I really got to figure out what to do about 9 points. Continuing on with that, I'm thinking of just putting it out as ebooks, for now, and then once we have a volume, we can do another Kickstarter. Yeah. It's a lot going on, and heck, I don't know what this video is. It's just kind of just me being a little sad, but trying my best. Like, I'm not depressed. Speaking of, like, someone telling me how I feel, I am very much not depressed right now, despite what it may seem. I'm having a really good time. I'm just worried about this one aspect of my life, and I kind of want to, like, address it a little bit. Like I keep saying, it's just for me. It's just for me to go, like, okay, Bones, here's where we're at. What are we going to do about it? So I need to sit down. There might not be, like, consistent videos for a while, especially as, like, the holidays begins up. Yeah, so there's not going to be super consistent videos until then. We're going to do our holiday card video that we did last year. We're going to make a new holiday card. We got, like, a giveaway thing going on in the Discord. You have to get in your fan art by December 15th. And if you do that, you get a card. You're also entered into a giveaway. It's all nice. It's all good. And we have the signups for Secret Santa Art Exchange on our Discord as well. And that's where everyone's going to get assigned a Secret Santa, and you're going to draw art for them. And someone secret is going to draw art for you. And it's all going to be a heckin' rad tubular time. And I'm really happy, excited about that. Yeah. And aside from that, I don't know what's going to happen for the channel right now. We're going to keep up with our live streams, so you won't have to think we're, like, dead or gone or something, but we're going to do that. Yeah. Thank you for listening to this and getting through all of it. Man. Cats and dogs just live to make you stressed and happy. It's so annoying, isn't it? Why do I like them so much? Okay. Talk to you later, and hopefully a video that you guys, like, actually want super bad. Tell me what fairy tale we want to redo. Okay, guys, give me fairy tale prompts, okay? Aside from all your comments, they're gonna be like, oh, it's okay, Bones, you're lovely and stuff. Okay, that's great, thank you. but actually, thank you. Aside from that, please leave comments to tell me what fairy tale you are interested in me retelling. And with that retelling, give me a prompt, as in, like, what kind of story you're telling. So be it mystery, fantasy, adventure, any type of thing, and then I'll show you how to plot one out. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. This is my actual goodbye. Signing off now. Adios. Goodbye.